Hello everyone! Today we're going to talk about how to work with text in InDesign. I prepared a sample document for you that you're going to use in this tutorial. You can download the data on our website and you find the link in the box under this YouTube video. You can download the data and open it, and now we can get started with the tutorial. One important concept of InDesign are styles. I can define styles, for example, for a paragraph. And if I do certain formatting with the paragraph, change the color, change the font, I can apply this formatting to other paragraphs. If you want to know what is my paragraph, it's a good idea to have hidden characters activated. I personally have this activated all the time because it gives you these blue symbols all over your text. And it's really useful also for other things that we're going to cover in later tutorials. You can define a lot of different styles in InDesign. You have paragraph styles and you have character styles. Character styles is the formatting of certain words in your paragraph. So I could say this tutorial, I could make this bold or italic. This would be a character style. But I also can define styles for tables and objects and other things. But I'm not going to cover this in this tutorial. We're going to concentrate on paragraphs and character styles. The first paragraph style I want to create is the style for our font. So we see, if we activate, we highlight this paragraph here. Currently we're using the font Garamond, and we can pop this up. And we see we have a T over here, and we have also some fonts with an O. T stands for true type, and O stands for open type. We should always use open type, because true type fonts have some problem sometimes between Mac and Windows, so they're not very compatible sometimes. So you can get in a lot of trouble when your text looks on a Windows machine in a different way than on a Mac. So just remember to always use O fonts, like open type fonts. I personally like Adobe Garamond Pro quite a lot, so we're going to choose this, and we see our text changed a little bit. This is a new font we choose, and we're going to create a new style, and it says now paragraph style 1, and we're going on edit and give this a new name. We say it's font, and also we're going to go on advanced formats, and we're going to choose our language we want to have this text in. So for example, if we live in the UK, we use English UK or US, depending which language you want to use. We choose UK in this case, go on OK. If I want to apply this formatting now to the other parts of the text, I can press Command A and select the whole text and go on font. And this applies this style to the whole text I have here. I see a little plus here, this means there are some character styles in here, so I don't want this. I say apply font and clear overrides, and now I have everything in the character, in the paragraph style. In the next step, we're going to look at our character styles. For example, I have here a Latin name in my text, so I want to have this in italic. I have a chemical compound like water in this case. I want the 2 to be subscript. Then we can go on. I have a formula in here, and the minus 2 should be, for example, superscript. And I have a reference in here, so I want to have this in small caps. You can also define some words as bold. And these are basically the most common formatting things you need. And we now need to define every single one as a character style. So we select this, go on A, and we create a new character style. Then we edit this and say it's italic. And we go on for this for all the other things. So this 2, we can call it down, the minus 2 over here, we can call it up, big, can be named as bold. And the small caps, I personally like to call it reference. So if we now take another part of the text, for example, we say problem, and we say we want to have this in bold, we just click on the specific character style, and we apply the formatting on this. We also can say we want this paragraph in, for example, in italic, and so on. So you get the idea. Now we want to work on our headlines. The first thing we want to do is to create a new folder to stay organized in our paragraph style menu, and we call this headlines. Then we create a new style and call it head 1. So I have selected the text over here, this should be my first headline, my first level, so to say. I go on edit, I never want to double click on this, because then I would set the head 1 paragraph style as my default paragraph style. I don't want to do this, so I always go on right click and edit. What we see now is that this paragraph style is based on a paragraph style we created before, on font. This defines actually which font am I using for my text, and if I would change the font, it would also change the font in all my headlines I have. So this is something you want in this case. Now we will apply some numbering, so we go on numbers, and if we have activated our preview checkbox, we also see the changes we do here in our text. And I personally like to have the space between the 1 and our text on 1 centimeter, but this is just a personal preference. And we also want to have the font style in bold. So this would be how our headlines look at the moment. I'm quite happy with this, so I can go on OK. Now I want to have this as a sub-headline. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to duplicate the style, because I want to have here a 1 and then 0.1 as a sub-headline. So I'm going to call this head 2, and I'm going to go on bullets and numbering, and I'm going to select the numbering here on level 2. Now I need to change the formatting in here. And I'm not going to go into what this means, because it's quite complicated, and you do this what we're doing now exactly one time and never again. So I'm just going to copy this. I prepared this before. And now we're going to go on OK. We still have this on head 1, so it just numbers this through. But we want this on head 2. And now we see this is 1.1. Our next subheadline, we say we also want this on head 2, and you get the idea, this continues. We can also add headlines on a third level, so I'm just going to add a new headline here, headline number 3, and to do this, we again just copy the style, call it head 3. Go on numbering. Now we need to copy this 1 over here and change this in 2. And we also change the level to 3. Click on OK. And we have our third level of headlines. The last step with paragraph styles would be to make our text look a little bit better. So what we want to do is we want to have it aligned properly, and I personally like to have a little indent over here that aligns with our headlines. So I also type in here 1 centimeter. The next thing, most theses have the requirement that you have a distance between your lines is a little bit increased, like 1.5 times. So we need to set this. This is under character styles. And at the moment it's on auto, so we need to do a little bit of math. So we take the 14.4 and multiply it by 1.5. This is 21.6 pt. And now we get it spaced out really nice. And one tip is also to activate the story mode. What this does, it aligns the letters a little bit different, that it looks better. If you look now at our paragraph styles, you see that I made a little mistake before. I choose the font, and the font has now a plus and says, well, you have now some changes here you shouldn't have. You should use character styles for this. So we would need to define a new paragraph. But one thing I want to show you here is you can clear the changes now again. If you select the paragraph, we have the changes that are certainly not character styles. You can go on clear overrides and you get rid of this again. And you also can change, you can get rid of your character styles if you go on here and say clear character styles. Now everything is back to normal, so to say. But we, of course, we want this, but we need to define a new paragraph style. I should have done this before, but I certainly didn't do it. I'm really sorry for this. And we say this is our basic text. So we want to use this text paragraph style for all our written text, and we basically never use our font style. The font style is just to define which font we are using. So we can check this in here, and we see it's based on font. This is all right. So now again, I need to press Command A to apply the basic text on everything, because at the moment we have on most parts the style font. We want basic text. But now you see it's pretty good that we have defined our headline styles. So we just can go head 1, head 2, head 2, and we done again. We have changed basically all the styles in here, and now it looks good, and this is how it should be. So we never use the font, we use the basic text for our basic text, so to say. One last thing we need to change now is the space between this and the headline. So you go on headline, go on edit. Oh, I can, by the way, I can show you another way to do this. You can also go on, you can do your changes directly in the style. So you can say, I want to have a little bit more space up here. So it would be 7.2 pt to get our 1.5 spacing. And we press return and we did apply this. And now we see we have again this plus over here. And if we go now on redefine style, it will redefine the style, and this, how we have it over here, is how we want to have it. So we say redefine style, and it automatically applies it to the other head 2 styles we have. We also need to do this change again for the first style, for the first headline style. So 0.2 pt. And again, we get the plus, and we say redefine style. It would have been better to do everything, to do the things with the basic text in the beginning, but as I said, I did forget it. I'm sorry for this. Now everything is how it should be. We have defined our basic paragraphs, we have defined our character styles, and we have everything that we need to go on with typing.